Greetings, Aquarius. The new moon takes place in your first house of attitudes and appearances. You are on a mission, Aquarius, and are open to change. But your mind may be focused a little too much on the future, which is blinding you to the benefits you are achieving in the present moment. You are restless and eager to get ahead, and this is probably due to the fact that for quite a while now, you have felt stuck in a rut, or restricted in some way, especially when it comes to your energy levels. But now it's like you are bursting at the seams, and woe betide anyone that gets in your way, or that is the way you are coming across. It's really just down to your restless nature and your eagerness to get ahead and your newfound ability to take a risk. Mercury is retrograding through your second house of finances and self-value. You have worked really hard at claiming your right to be your own person, but may be a little too rigid with your boundaries. You need to relax and try to stay grounded in the present moment and allow the process to unfold in its own time. Meditate on staying grounded and focused on your daily routine. Change is needed, but not at all cost. Greetings, Pisces. The new moon takes place in your 13th house of the hidden. Maybe you are taking a break from the external world, and even from social media. And if you are, I'm sure you're doing the right thing for the moment. Your sensitivity is still very high and has been for quite some time. You are a highly spiritual sign, but may be going through some changes regarding this area of your life. We are all going through shifts of consciousness at the moment, but for you, these shifts may also be creating some confusion with your own self-identity. It's not easy for a Pisces in general to be fully in touch with their true self, since they are quite the chameleon of the zodiac. It is so important that you avoid negative situations or people at this time and concentrate on yourself. Mercury is retrograding through your first house of attitudes and appearances. Don't be impatient with yourself and allow yourself the time needed for your inner transformation to unfold in divine timing. This would also be a good time for you to reflect on creating healthy boundaries and connect to your inner self. Crafting, creating, and sound baths will be very healing and a good source for you to understand your own emotions or what needs to be healed. Greetings, Aries. The new moon takes place in your 12th house of friends and groups, but there seems to be a lot of changes going on, either within them or within the way you're thinking regarding them. You are very focused on your work or moving forward in your life. Things have really shifted for you, either mentally, emotionally, or physically, and your passion for something or someone has returned. But it could also be to do with something creative. There also seems to be a lot of psychic activity going on with you, or you are questioning your instincts or suppressing them. Uranus has now reached 1 degree in your sign, so your consciousness is really beginning to expand in some way, maybe regarding your spiritual views. Mercury is retrograding through your 13th house of the hidden, so you could be reflecting on the past, past circumstances, past relationships, or past ideas. The only problem with this placement is that you could be viewing these situations a little bit too deeply, which could be quite overwhelming for you at times. Or you could be going over and over things that were said or things that were done. The past is the past, Aries. It's the future that counts. Greetings, Taurus. The new moon takes place in your 11th house of career and public status. There seems to be an imbalance within your commitments, whether this be your work, finances, or an intimate relationship. Although you have a way of smoothing over any difficulties, it is actually putting quite a lot of pressure on you. And these are issues that have been ongoing on and off for quite some time now. You are an all or nothing kind of person, Taurus. But lately you may be feeling a bit confused as to what it is you really want or how to get it. Maybe you just wish that others could be on the same wavelength as you and see things your way. Maybe your finances are at the root cause of all the uneasiness that surrounds you at the moment. Mercury is retrograding through your 12th house of friends and groups. Maybe you just need to give yourself the space to think and come to your own conclusions. Maybe your expectations are a little bit too high, or it is another or others that have these expectations of you. Beware of chasing rainbows, as you are likely to be more in your head than in your heart throughout this time. Meditation would be a good way for you to give you the space that you need. Greetings, Gemini. The new moon takes place in your 10th house of your inner temple and sacred knowledge. Maybe you are on a search for spiritual understandings, or you are reflecting on past injustices. Or, Gemini, it could be that you have gone up a level on your spiritual journey, which often leaves us feeling empty of knowledge when once we felt we knew so much. And this is quite common when we level up. You are now on a new search to recreate your identity that is fitting to your new path in life. Don't underestimate yourself or underestimate others. It is time for you to put in the work and research your new subject with the dedication and open-mindedness that is needed. Mercury, your ruling planet, is retrograding through your 11th house of career and public status, which further emphasizes the fact that you are now on a new path of discovery. Maybe you are reflecting on your past a little bit too much when it comes to your status and achievements, and are finding it hard to let go. Give yourself the time needed to adapt to your new path and concentrate on building your new identity. Maybe meditating on your heart chakra will be beneficial. Greetings, Cancer. The new moon takes place in your 9th house of endings of cycles, and you are probably finding it very hard to concentrate and focus at present. It seems that you have been triggered by an event that has stirred your heart, and you are feeling a great need to retreat and focus on your own well-being. The problem is that when you go into your shell, you can drift off into the realms of fantasy or get too much into your head. Although healthy self-nurture would serve you well throughout this time, so will indulging into your craft. Actually, this would be a very good time for you to nurture your feminine side and accept that it's all right to be in your feelings. Mercury is retrograding through your 10th house of the inner temple and emphasizing the need for you to get out of your head and go within. Your soul is evolving and your old self is coming to an end. You are in need of finding a new meaning to your life and allow what no longer serves you to fall away. It is not a time for you to retreat from the physical world, Cancer, but it is a time to work on your inner being and rummage through the confusion to find the new you and your new passion in life. Greetings, Leo. The new moon takes place in your 8th house of karma and shared resources, and shows that a balance is needed, either in your finances or within your relationships. Or maybe you are weighing up the pros and cons of your future direction. Whatever the case, Things may be out of sync and is affecting your well-being. Beware of burning the candle at both ends. Let go of past patterns of behavior and be realistic about what you want. Get creative and out of your head, as your thoughts can be filled with unrealistic expectations. Mercury is retrograding through your ninth house of ending of cycles and shows that you are not centered and may be taking life or yourself a little bit too seriously. You are very much in your thoughts and reasoning, where your questioning mind just leads you into asking further questions. Maybe you need to question what your question actually is, Leo. Working on centering yourself through meditation, yoga, or Tai Chi will help you to bring yourself back into alignment with your health and focus. Greetings, Virgo. The new moon takes place in your seventh house of relationships and shows that an intimate relationship has your full attention at this time. Or it could be that you are reviewing your relationship status. Your mind is sharp, but you still seem to be a bit shut down emotionally or feeling a bit out of balance, as your nervous energy is quite high at the moment, which can make you come across as unreachable. Your ruling planet Mercury is retrograding through your eighth house of shared resources and karmic patterns, and shows that you are reflecting on and evaluating your partnership or partnerships in general from both the past and the present. If you are finding it difficult to express yourself intimately, it's probably because you are too much in your head and not enough in your body. Maybe it's time for you to listen to your own advice, Virgo, and work on your mind-body health by raising your vibration and accepting your place in this world, wherever you are currently at. Greetings, Libra. The new moon takes place in your sixth house of health and work, and things seem to be getting quite busy for you. You may also be considering a new health regime too. You are on pretty good form at the moment, or at least you are determined to turn things around and have some fun. Although relationships are still a top priority of your focus at this time, there may be some difficulty though, Libra, in maintaining equilibrium in your home environment. Mercury is retrograding through your seventh house of relationships and shows that this is the area where balance is needed. It could be an intimate relationship or a close friend or family member is distracting you from focusing on your own needs. Maybe you feel at a loss with what to do. Nurture your own soul, Libra, and stay in a place of unconditional love. Greetings, Scorpio. The new moon takes place in your fifth house of creativity and youth. Maybe you are fed up with the same old, and feel a need to express yourself creatively. Although it also seems that you are giving yourself a hard time in taking the time needed to do this, or maybe your confidence levels are blocking you. For some, it could be to do with relationships and your expectations of them. Control issues are the usual status quo for you, Scorpio, either your self-control or your control over others. Your tolerance levels are probably being tested at the moment, and you would be wise to just let things be. Mercury is retrograding through your sixth house of health and being of service, which emphasizes the need for you to focus on your own self and your own health, or your own path in life. Or maybe you are being too harsh on yourself or too harsh on others. Meditation would be very beneficial for you, throughout this time, especially meditations around the root and sacral chakras, to help you express your creative side. Greetings, Ophiuchus. The new moon takes place in your fourth house of home and family. Maybe it's a good time to start a new routine or shift the energy in some way. A new healthy routine around diet and exercise may be on your mind. But whatever the case, it is time for you to step into your spiritual power. Jupiter is still in your sign and is helping you to expand and grow in your outlook and life experiences. There could be some confusion about your life's direction, but all will be revealed when the time is right. Maybe some time away from your environment will help you to return with a fresh perspective. Mercury is retrograding through your fifth house of creativity and youth. There seems to be a lack of focus or distractions when it comes to being productive and creative. Maybe there is a need for you to get out of your head and into action or focus. Although you are getting a lot of insights and ideas, you are finding it difficult to put them into practice. Meditation and walks in nature will help you to refresh your stamina. Greetings, Sagittarius. The new moon takes place in your third house of your inner child and local environment, which shows that you are probably finding it hard to keep still, both mentally and physically. You are ready for change, but may need to get a grip on your self-discipline so that you can direct all this energy into something constructive. Or maybe you need to work on restructuring your life in some way. Beware of over-optimism and take note of your instincts. They could be helpful in assisting you in the right direction. Mercury is retrograding through your fourth house of home and family, which shows that a lot of reflection on your close relationships could be distracting you from making the changes that are needed in your life. Reflecting on your past way of thinking will only keep you in confusion, so connect to your heart and take a step back and let go of unhealthy relationships with unconditional love. Greetings, Capricorn. The new moon takes place in your second house of finances and self-value. And it seems that the focus is set on developing healthy boundaries and self-love. Your aim is to discover who you truly are and how to reflect that. It's time for you to step into your personal power and embrace your self-discipline. Just beware of escapism and continue on working on being productive. But also be patient with yourself, because time is needed in this area. Mercury is retrograding through your third house of the inner child and local environment, and shows a need for you to develop your inner strength, especially when it comes to your self-expression. You are an analytical thinker, but may be wary of people and their true agendas, and also wary of being misunderstood by them, which can hamper your ability to speak the truth. Although for some, you may need to be more aware of how you communicate and develop your sense of self-worth.